This is the Math 2 lesson summary video for infectious exponents. In this lesson, the purpose of infectious exponents is to determine how to calculate values of an exponential function that occur between whole number inputs. In the first part of the lesson, we are told that bacteria grows exponentially, and we start with 300 bacteria, and they're doubling every hour. So the first thing we're asked to do is we're asked to fill out this chart here, which I've done for you. For multiplying each by 2, we can see that the next value here would be 600, the next value here would be 1200, 2400, and 4800. So each value is being multiplied by 2 or doubling every hour. We are then asked to plot this at the end of the task. So if I scroll to my graph, I took those data points and I actually plotted those here on the coordinate grid that was given to us. So then we're told that we want to find out how many bacteria there would be after 30 minutes. So instead of every 1 hour, which we know is the bacteria is doubling, so I'm just going to fill that in. This was 600 after the first hour. After the second hour, that would be 1,200 bacteria. After the third hour, that would be 2,400 bacteria. And after the fourth hour, that would be 4,800 bacteria. But we're asked to find how many bacteria there would be after 30 minutes. So Travis makes a claim. He says that he thinks that if the number of bacteria doubles every hour, then half of that growth should occur between 0 and 1 half. So he's saying because the difference between 600 and 300 is actually 300, that we should be able to divide 300 in half and get what the difference should be between 0 minutes and 30 minutes. So he's saying that the bacteria should grow by 150. So 300 plus 150 bacteria, he's saying that this at 30 minutes should be 450 bacteria. So if we keep going along those lines, and we use that same strategy, between 600 and 1200 bacteria, that is a difference of 600. So we need to add 300 to 600. So he's saying that in an hour and a half, we'd have 900 bacteria. So on and so forth. At 2.5 hours, we'd have 1800 bacteria. And at 3.5 hours, we'd have 3600 bacteria. So then we were asked in number 4 to comment on Travis's idea and how it compares to the table generated in problem 1. So let's just scroll up to problem 1 for a moment. If we look at the table in problem 1, we already discussed that we are multiplying our initial bacteria count of 300 by 2. And we were multiplying by 2 each time, which we saw in our table up top. So if we go back to math 1, if you recall the MVP lesson geometric meanies, we understand that when we are multiplying by the same number each time in a sequence, that it is not arithmetic, or linear, but when we are multiplying by a common ratio, that is what we called it in math 1, when we multiply by a common ratio, it is actually exponential. And if we look back up at the directions here, bacteria typically grow exponentially. So we can see in the sequence in number 1 that this is definitely not a linear function because we are not adding a common difference. We are multiplying by a common ratio. So let's go back down to number 4. So since our function is an exponential function, we were asked to determine if Travis's method was appropriate. Travis's thinking is actually linear, so therefore Travis's thinking is not actually appropriate for the bacteria count. So we'll just write that down. Travis is treating the interval in between whole numbers inputs as if f of x is a linear function. And we know for certain that it's not a linear function because we are multiplying by a common ratio, not adding by a common difference. So then we moved on to number 5, and we read that Miriam suggests that we fill in the table using her strategy. So does she notice that the number of bacteria increases by the same factor of 2, which we've just discussed from problem number 1 on the previous page? To Miriam, it seems that the function should probably still increase by a common factor because it is a geometric sequence over each half interval. So in number 5, we were asked to try and find what that common factor would be. So in class, what we discussed is that if we are trying to figure out every 30 minutes and the half mark, if we took our starting bacteria of 300 and we multiplied it by the square root of 2, we should be able to get that starting value. So if I go back to my calculator and I type in 300, which is our starting number of bacteria, times the square root of 2, I get that after 30 minutes, there should be 424.26 bacteria. So I'm going to write that right here in my table. So it was 424, approximately 0.26. Okay. And then we look to see what was happening at an hour and a half, how many bacteria that would be. So if we think of this constant factor, what that would mean is that if square root of 2 is my constant factor, that when I multiplied by the square root of 2 again times my next value, so I should be able to type in square root of times the square root of 2 again, and it will take my answer from the previous line and multiply by the square root of 2. So you can see that the number of bacteria after 1 hour is 600, which holds true based on our table. So my calculator knows that I'm multiplying by the square root of 2, so I can just hit enter and it will multiply by the square root of 2 again. So after an hour and a half, we should have 848.52 approximately, and 53 if we round up bacteria. So 848.53. I'm going to use a different color. So that's 848.53. And we continued along those lines and we filled in this table using Marion's strategy. So at 2.5 hours, we should have 1,697.06. At 3.5 hours, we should have 3,394.11 bacteria. So what I'm going to do just on a separate page is I'm just going to write out, so we started with 300 times the square root of 2, and then we did 300, and of course the index is 2, times the square root of 2 times the square root of 2. So 300 times the square root of 2 gave us that 424.26 bacteria, and then when we multiplied that by itself twice, we got 600. And if we keep going, we can multiply that 3 times, square root of 2 times itself 3 times, and we should get 848.53. And I can keep going on that. I start with 300 bacteria, and I'm going to add another square root of 2, which would then yield 1,200 bacteria. So this pattern keeps going along just as so. So you're going to multiply by that common ratio, and because it's every half an hour, we're just adding that square root of 2 each time. In the last part of number 5, it does ask us to plot Miriam's data on the graph at the end of this task. So if I go back to this graph, you can see that the blue dotted line is actually Travis's thinking, his linear thinking about the bacteria, and the green line, the curve, is actually Miriam's thinking about the data. In number 6, we were asked, what if Miriam wanted to find the number of bacteria for every 1/3 of an hour? And how many minutes would this be? So we already know at every hour we're going to double the amount of bacteria. So I've already filled that in. And the next thing is then to figure out we're starting with 300 and we need to find that constant multiplier. So of course we can use the calculator. Some students did guess and check. But this value would be times the cube root of 2. So if I come to my calculator, you can see that 300 times the cube root of 2 would yield 377.97 bacteria. So we've added that to our chart. And then after 2/3 of an hour, we would multiply that value by the same constant ratio or multiplier. So again, that would be times the cube root of 2. And that would give us 476.22 bacteria. So I'm going to add that to my table and try and squeeze it in here because I'm running low on space. So 476.22. We already know at the 1 hour mark we would have 600 bacteria, but just to show you now, I can hit enter on my calculator and it should multiply by that same common ratio. And I can keep hitting enter to get the next number in my sequence since I'm multiplying by the same number each time. So that's how we're going to fill in our table. And you can see then there's my 1200, that's after 2 hours. And my next values. And then after 3 hours, we should get 2400. So all those values check out. And we're just going to write those in the table. So 4/3 was 755. And I'm just going to round to 0.95. I'm going to put an arrow because I'm losing a little bit of space. 952.44 bacteria. We have 1511.91 and 1904.88. Okay, so now in number 7, we were asked what was the constant factor that we used in number 5, and we determined that was the square root of 2. We also had some students guess and check. So if you take a look at the square root of 2 is approximately 1.41, and some students use that number to approximate the next number in the table. And then on number 8, what did we use? What was our constant factor in number or problem 6? And that was 1.2599, or the cube root of 2, which if we also try and compare the cube root of 2, I can do math. Number 4 and the cube root of 2, and that would be 1.2599. And then if we were to evaluate and we plugged in 1/3 into our function, so what that's saying is if we do f of 1/3 and we plug 1/3 in for x, it's asking us, will we get the same decimal values we did in the table? And yes, we can double check that. And the same thing on 10, if we plug in 7/3 for x times 2 to the 7/3, we do get the same thing from the table, 1511.91. So in number 11, we were asked to estimate the number of bacteria when the time was 5/3 or x was 5/3. And so we would plug in 5/3. And essentially, what does that mean? Well, what that means is that we're going to take our multiplier and multiply it 5 times. And in this case, what we would be multiplying by is the cube root of 2 5 times. So we're taking the cube root of 2 and we're going to write it out 5 times. And that would estimate the number of bacteria when x was 5/3. If you need any help on the Ready, Set, Go homework for this task, please remember to check the Canvas student support site.